Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go. Dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker. Hi, and welcome to Knitting on the Float. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host. And I am coming to you from a gloriously sunny day in Vancouver. There are harsh shadows, but I don't care because it's sunny out. And with sunshine comes warmth. Apparently we're supposed to have a heat wave in Vancouver this weekend. Only I get excited about a heat wave. I try my best not to complain about the heat because when it is cold, I absolutely hate it. So bitter cold is my bitter enemy. So if a heat wave comes, I really try my best to embrace it and love every moment of it, even if I am sweltering hot, because heat for me is so much better than cold. I hope that you have had a fantastic week wherever you are. Did you take up my challenge to try something new? I am excited to tell you that I met my challenge and my challenge was accepted, and I'm going to share my progress, which has been pretty good, I think, on that project, but we'll get to that at the end of my favorite things. I do have a couple of things to share on brown paper packages. I think next week is going to be a bumper week for brown paper packages. I was very naughty, but I have one that I'm going to introduce in my favorite things because that was the project that I did, but we'll get to that in a little bit. Before I do that, let me tell you where you can find me. I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Knitting on the Float on Instagram. If you're new to the podcast, welcome. I am so happy to have you join me, and I hope that you have a chance to sit down, relax, do some crafting while I share with you some of the things that I've been up to this week and over the past few weeks. So welcome. And if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. I am always so happy just to have you join me on the couch or the red chairs. I know you're giving Scout a scratch behind the ear. She's over by the door. Tasha is actually sitting on the couch with us today. So welcome back. Get snuggled in, get your project of choice, your beverage of choice, ta-da-da, and let's start off with some tea time before we start chattering about the projects that have gotten some love over here. So, tea time, and I am drinking out of my lovely Rendale Designs Pink Ladies mug. Pink flamingos, always so lovely. I can't remember if I mentioned last week that I think I put it in as a written caption. Isaac's residence is called Flamingo Crossings. That's where all the college students stay in Disney World. So today I am enjoying drinking with flamingos and just plain Marks and Spencer tea. This afternoon I'm having one of the neighbors over and we're going to have some crafting time. So I'm going to introduce a completely different craft than are on here, which I'll be able to share with you next week. And we're going to be drinking decaf this afternoon. So I'm getting my Marks and Spencer extra strong caffeinated tea in now. And I think today I did take my challenge, changed it up a little bit. So let us say cheers to changing things up every so often. Sometimes I think these Rendale Designs mugs are a bit small. Couple gulps and I'm now halfway through. That's okay. It's a good shot of caffeine. So this week on my favorite things, I worked on three different projects, but I'm going to be talking about four. The first project I'm going to share with you is Living in My Happy Homemaker Bag. This is by Birdleg Bags. It's not actually called the Happy Homemaker Bag. That's what I have called it. This one is casserole dishes, carrots, spoons, onions, little fun things from around the kitchen. And to me, that's my happy homemaker bag. This is my Ever After shawl. And it's gotten a little bit more love this week. Last week I did one repeat and I left the marker where I had started last week. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you how much I've done in the past 2 weeks, and then I'm going to hopefully remember to move the marker. For this project, I am using this lovely combo, which was a Nora George Yarns shawl kit. It is on merino silk, so it is shiny and lovely to work with. This gorgeous pink and this gorgeous, I want to call it a dove gray. It's almost like a silver gray, and knitting up beautifully. I am, and I will reach forward and grab these. Take my little baby scissors out. I am using, I think these are Toho beads. Toho 8 silver lined crystals. So just regular sparkly beads. And I had poured into my little container, and I'm using a small crochet hook to knit my beads on. Many, many moons ago, I did a little snippet at the end, I think, sharing how I do beads. And so these are the same, just a different container, but same color, sparkly goodness. Anyway, this is the Ever After shawl, and this is a pattern by Helen Stewart. It was part of the KnitVent 2021 selection patterns, KnitVents, and started off with the gorgeous gray, and then started into some striping with the pink and gray. And now we are in this lovely set of chevron lace with beads. Now, I left you off, or last time I left you off, I was at the top of this pink. I had picked this up and I started there. I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 repeats since I picked this up a couple of weeks ago. So while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to move my lovely little dragon to the top. And last night when I finished off this row, I hit 50%. So I am halfway done, and I think it's knitting up beautifully. There are a couple little things that I've done wrong. This was a test knit. If I were releasing it on that day, I would go back and I would fix it. But right now they are beautiful extra design additions. And let me find one for you. One of my chevrons, I was a little bit off. I was probably watching something on YouTube and distracted. It's good that I can't find it straight away. I can find it when I'm knitting. I think it's right here. I have one of my chevrons. I've got the yarn over in the wrong place. So, took me a while to find it, so that's pretty good. Once it's all blocked, maybe you'll see it a little bit more, but really, if people are looking for those little flaws, they got too much time on their hands. Anyway, this is a gorgeous design. The sunshine, I hope, is catching those beads and the glorious silk in this yarn so that you can see the shine. And I just love a delicate pink and gray. And this one is making me very, very happy. I'm not sure what I would like my timeline to be on this. I think I'm just, what I've been doing is I've been picking up this challenge project for a little bit each day. My eyes can only handle so much. And then I've been working on this. So I would love to get through the chevron lace section by the time I visit with you next. But if I don't, that's okay. But I could see that happening. And then I'm really on to the last little bit of the shawl, but 50% is feeling very, very good. I dropped my fancy jewelry. Good thing it's not made of breakable things. And I will put this back in Happy Homemaker to get some more attention, hopefully, this upcoming week. And again, I'm not really putting too much pressure on myself to finish it by a quick deadline, but I would like it done in the next few weeks. Maybe by mid-July would be really great, I think. Anyway, that is one project that definitely got some love. The next project I'm going to share with you, we are going into spoiler alert. This one is the first of my Miss May shawls. This one is the actual test knit, so the one that was knit before the pattern was released. And after I do that, I'm going to go into my second Miss May shawl. So we're in spoiler alert for a little while. I hope you kind of like the spoiler alert stuff. I know I always do. I have pre-recorded a segment where I have shared my Clue 3 from my original knit using these gorgeous Viola Merino 4-ply yarns. And this is 100% Merino. I have purple is Thistle, this light blue is Lagoon, this dark blue is Summer Night, and this green is Sogging River. And they have knit up beautifully together, as most Viola yarns do. I do have 4 more full skeins of this yarn. I'm not sure what I will make with those, but it is nice to know I do have those. And Viola yarns are always so, so lovely. So I am going to, through the magic of editing, take you back several weeks to where I finished Clue 3 and was about to start Clue 4. So through the magic of editing, I am now going to share Clue 3 with you of the Miss May Mystery Knit Along by Curious Handmade, Helen Stewart. And before I share the clue that I've just finished, I am going to talk about my yarns. I am using beautiful Viola Merino 4-ply, and color A is this gorgeous skein of Field Thistle. Color B is this lovely dark blue Summer Nights. My color C is Lagoon. Look at those gorgeous speckles. And color D is Sogging River. And lots of gorgeous speckles in here, and just a lovely yarn. All of them are lovely yarns to work with. So we are now on Clue 3, and here are 1, 2, and then Clue 3 is bringing back Gorgeous Lagoon in lace, and then we are revisiting a twisted ribbing, very similar to the one that you see in Clue 1. So a nice, easy, gentle clue, a little bit of lace, a little bit of ribbing, not too mind taxing, and it is nice. We now have all of our colors introduced, and then we are reintroducing these two again. So Lagoon and Sogging River. So far, I think it is knitting up beautifully. And of course, we're not even finished or getting ready to be blocked, but I think it is going to be absolutely gorgeous once it is all done. So there are 2 more clues. I am about to start Clue 4. Any guesses on next colors? We will see. And then, of course, there is Clue 5 left to go. So 2 more clues. We are more than halfway there. I hope that you are loving your mystery knit along so far, participating in it, and also the colors that you have chosen. So that right there is my lovely Viola Miss May shawl. Clues 1, 2, and 3. And as I said, I'm ready to start Clue 4 now. That gorgeous project had been living in my lovely butterfly celebration bag by Bryony and Jules of So Sweet Violet. I love this bag, and this fabric makes me so happy. And then, of course, there's the butterfly with the hand-sewn sequins. It's hard to see with the sunshine, but again, not complaining. Okay, we are still in spoiler alert because I am going to share with you my progress up to the end of clue 3 of my second Miss May shawl. And for my second Miss May shawl, I am using the remaining yarns from my Hedgehog Fiber Find Your Fade kit. And the colors for this, and I will go from the red down to the yellow, are Poison, Crush, Rosehip, Monarch, this little small one right here, and I will pull that out because that's the one I used this week. It's been really wonderful using the last little bits. So this is Harvest, and then my remaining two colors are Fool's Gold and Pollen. And I may have played a little bit with my fade, and you'll see what I mean in a moment. I just wanted to switch it up a little bit, and I think it's gonna look really neat as a final project, once it's finally all blocked and done. So if you don't want to see, close your eyes, cover your ears, run screaming out of the room, do what you need to do. This is my Miss May up to the end of clue 3. So we started off with clue 1 with the reds and pinks. Clue 2 was the gorgeous monarch in this lace. I've popped this on my barber cord. And then, sorry, did I say clue 2? Clue 2 is the monarch. And clue 3, and I'm trying to stretch it out, I used Harvest. And then, as I said, I popped down to Pollen because I just thought that would add a little bit more visual interest to have that solid. And this is the clue 3 that I finished the other day, just before the clue was released for everyone else. And so I'm knitting just a little ahead of everybody. And I just love how this is knitting up. It's going to look even better once it is blocked. Now, I did make the intentional effort to bury my yarns in my I-cord on this version. I completely forgot on my other version, so I'm going to have to sew in ends. I haven't done it yet. I still also have to film clue 5 for my test knit, but I've been having so much fun re-knitting this shawl that I just haven't got to it yet. I did sew the ends in on my Find Your Fade though, I just haven't blocked that. Anyway, this is the beautiful Miss May shawl, and I hope that if you are knitting it, you are loving it. I know some people were concerned that the lace didn't quite line up to the clue before, but I think you will be very happy with the end results once it is all said and done. So I did change things up by going with this color here. I will be on this one resuming back with the Fool's Gold to sort of get that fade going again, even though, like I said, I broke up the fade a little bit, but I think once it's all said and done, I think I'll be very, very happy that I did. I did question myself, but I think just having that nice block of solid at this point will really make this a very striking shawl, I hope. Anyway, that is what is living in my gorgeous Bird Leg Bags nest bag with the vintage floral and the pink gingham. And I was sharing this project bag with someone the other day. They loved it. They said, oh my gosh, it has pockets. Vicky's bags really are so, so wonderful. And I've been enjoying using this one. So I will be using the updated pattern for clue 4 once I receive that, just to double check before it goes out to everybody. And so once I get that, I will be knitting away exclusively on this, and then working on other projects around it. But next week, I do hope to share this with you, and I think you'll be very pleased with yours once you've sort of got all your clues together. If you are knitting the Miss May shawl, I think you're going to be really, really pleased with your final outcome. The fact that I have knit 2 says a lot about this pattern. Anyway, I don't think I mentioned the Miss May is a mystery knit along. The pattern is by Helen Stewart, who is Curious Handmade, and I always love Helen's patterns. And again, this one, no different. Okay, final thing that I worked on this week was my challenge to myself. And my challenge to myself was to do something other than knitting. So that could have been crochet, it could have been learning to do some quilting. There's some hand quilting I wanted to do. Some English paper piecing. It could have been anything, but what I chose to do was to do cross stitch. Now, I used to absolutely love doing cross stitch, but as I have aged, my eyes have not been as kind to me, and I find that it's not as easy to do the cross stitch anymore. And sometimes it's a little difficult to find the materials that I want to use for cross stitch, because I like particular materials. I like working with linen a lot. I really don't like Aida cloth. I do have some linen, but you know, it's kind of precious. So when I find something I absolutely love, that's when I want to use it. And a couple of weeks ago, I was snooping around on the internet like so many of us do. And I came across a really interesting pattern. So this is the first of one of my brown paper packages, but introduced in the My Favorite Things segment. I found this amazing cross-stitch pattern of Nancy Drew, The Secret of the Old Clock. And this is one of the hardcover book covers, and I just thought it was brilliant. And I will put the got it from Etsy, and I'll put the Etsy seller down here. But I just thought this was amazing. A lot of work, but really different. And where I don't have a lot of wall space, I thought I could make a bag out of this, or a pillow, or I could frame it and put it on the wall, because it would look pretty amazing. Anyway, this is what I purchased this past week, and along with that, I made a list of threads, and as I got them, I circled them. I only have 3 more threads left to get, but it doesn't really matter for this pattern, and you'll see in brown paper packages what I'm talking about. So I took up the challenge and I bought myself some linen. This is a T-stain DMC even weave linen. And I'm just going to pop it onto the hoop because that makes it a little easier to see. And I should have loosened the hoop a little bit first. And this is definitely a very complex pattern. It is not on one page like patterns I'm used to. It is on several pages, and so it's just block by block broken down, which makes it a little easier to see, which is great, but it does make it quite complex. So on Saturday, I prepped my linen, and I'm going to cover over the design that I've worked on so far for now, so I can hopefully share with you how I prepped my linen. So I have a little line of blue going up and down all the way from the middle of the top and the middles of the sides, making an axis, a cross, and then you count from there. Now, I really love to work with linen over 8 o'clock, but linen is a little bit more complex. Where Ada, square by square, and if you have half squares, you just have to break the spot in the middle of Ada. With linen, basically each square is 2 threads by 2 threads. So it's not 1 by 1, it's 2 by 2, and you really have to be counting. However, if you have half stitches, working with linen is definitely a lot easier. Harder on the eyes sometimes, but usually the half stitches, they're rare, depends on what pattern you're using. I don't think there will be any half stitches in this. If you noticed, I am using my new So Sweet Violet pin holder, and my pin likes to roll off it. And I have done a little bit of work. I've been working on Nancy's face and a little bit of her hair and her arm, and I've just been going through choosing color by color. So here is mine, and the reason I started there was because it was in the center, and if you can see my light blue lines there, I just started with the center and I'm working out, and it'll be interesting when I get to the next pages. I have gotten to the next pages a little bit at the top here, on the edge here, and down here. And I've just had to really, using that center line, make sure I have counted correctly. And of course, using the other stitches. But it felt so good to pick up cross stitch again. I've always loved doing it. I just, like I said, my eyesight isn't as good as it used to be. Thankfully, the shadows aren't as harsh right now, but there is a lot of light that comes in through the window beside me. So during the daytime with my glasses on, I can work for an hour or two on this, and it feels good. But look, you can see the emergence of a face happening. And I'm just trying to do, I'd like to try and do at least one strand of 6 each day. And I'll talk about the strands in my brown paper packages because I've purchased something to help me with my threads. Anyway, that is my challenge project that I am definitely very excited to share with you, and will hopefully get some love in the next little while. At this moment, it does not have a project bag, but there might be one on the way. Anyway, most important thing to do with cross stitch is to remove the hoop, otherwise you will get these awful lines on your linen. But so far, so good. And honestly, I love Nancy Drew. So this project makes me super, super happy. This week on Brown Paper Packages, I did buy lots and lots of DMC threads. I think I shared with you my list. I went through and figured out which colors I already had and which ones I needed, or which ones I was low on that I was going to need, and went to, unfortunately, the only place I could find DMC threads was Michaels, and went to Michael's. Not that Michael's is bad, but I do prefer a small shop if possible. I know you knit in Toronto, so DMC, but I'm not in Toronto anymore, so Michael's it is. While I was at Michael's, I did purchase another Irish linen tea stain. So this is a second one, so I've got two. And there is a serious method behind my madness, and you'll see that in a few minutes. So that was a 28 count even weave linen. I have two now, so one's being worked on. The other one I will keep in here until I get to that next project. Now, I did, as I mentioned, buy quite a few threads, and I also ordered myself some of these Loran cards. I love these. I had to order them online though because I used to be able to buy them at a store called Lewis Craft, which was a nice little chain store in Canada that sold craft supplies, and they had a wonderful cross stitch section. It was small, but it was wonderful, and that's where I first discovered these Loran cards. And what they are they're just cardboard, but and in the past I have done just getting some cardboard and cutting out, but I just love these and it helps me to keep my threads organized a little bit more. And they pop into a three ring binder, and then you just put 15 threads and then you can label them as you like. So if you're working on a project and you're just using those threads, or if, like me, I like to have them in numerical order. Doesn't always work out that way. But this is my embroidery floss binder. It is not quite big enough. I have had these Loran cards for years, and they do sometimes get a little bit old, but and pop out. But they are, you know, I've got lots and lots of threads. So as I said, I went through my binder to see what I needed, and my binder is a little small to fit these four in, but these are all of the new threads that I purchased. I have 3.5 cards full. I'm still needing three more, so a little more than 3.5 cards will be full once I have all of my threads together for my Nancy Drew projects. And I will share that with you in a few minutes. I did put them in numerical order in the order that I got them. Oh my gosh, look at that combination. It looks so, so beautiful. Anyway, this is my DMC thread replenish. And as I said, I'm trying to use at least one floss worth. So I've cut them. And the great thing about these two, I forgot to mention. So let me just grab. I don't know if you've ever had these ones. I don't love them. But the great thing about these MasterCards is they are perfect to wrap your threads around. And then they work out to a really nice length, and then I just, where I started it and where it ends, I snip at the top and then I wrap my threads around and pull through. So the card itself is great for measuring those threads. I'm not sure why I have these, but I do. I should probably put this on a card. That would make me happier. Anyway, what I'm trying to do is to pull one of these cut threads out, and this would be with the cross stitch. I'm using two strands from each of the six plied DMCs. So it gives me basically three full areas that I can work on with one strand of thread, because I'm using two together, two together, two together equals six, if that makes sense. Anyway, so I'm trying to do at least one of those a day, and then little by little I will get through that secret of the old clock pattern. I have one more purchase to share with you on brown paper packages, and yes, I purchased this pattern, but I also purchased this pattern too. So The Secret in the Old Attic. And I just think the two of these together are fabulous. So I started off with this one because remember I mentioned that I'm missing three threads. I'll find them. Those three threads are in The Secret of the Old Clock. So I know that my local Michaels will be getting one of those threads in this weekend, and then hopefully the other two will be on order not too long. The great thing about the Michaels website is I can just type in DMC in the number and it tells me where they are available. There are the other threads available, but they're farther away. If I happen to be passing that area, I might stop by and try and pick them up, but I'm not rushing because do you know how long it's going to take me to get through this one, let alone get to this one? Anyway, hence the reason I have this is because I also want to do this. I had thought about putting them both on the same linen and then framing them with like a divider in the middle, but I decided to do them as two separate projects. I could always sew them together in the center and then have something like a split mat put over them, but I think I'll just keep them separate. And I think they just look so amazing. I wish that The Mystery at Lilac Inn was one of the patterns, but it is not. Anyway, these were my sneaky purchases this week. And as I mentioned, I love Nancy Drew. So this one was a really hard one to pass up. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And I'm trying to think, I did so much extra crafting this week and branching out into the cross stitch, which I hadn't done for so long, that I really spend a lot of time focusing on getting those threads. On Friday night, I had to go and pick up a sleeping bag that Purolator was supposed to deliver, but they took to their warehouse out by the airport, so I had to go out by the airport yet again, and there was a Michaels there. So that's where I stopped at the Michaels before I went and picked up the sleeping bag for Isaac. And then I got as many of those threads as possible, came home, circled the ones that I got, and then the next day went out to another Michaels in Surrey and got all but three. So slowly, slowly getting there. My closest Michaels said it had one of the colors in stock, so when we went out earlier this week to get some groceries, we stopped in there and they did not have that color, which was very, very sad. But he did tell me that one was on order and then the other two, who knows, but hopefully they'll be in a reasonable amount of time. But again, no rush because who knows how long it's going to take me to get through. It usually takes me about an hour to do a square inch, and that's if I'm just using one color, and this one I'm using multiple colors, as you can tell by my list of all the colors that I will need. Isaac has been adjusting to life in Florida. He completed the Disney lifeguard training last weekend, so he was successful getting that, which I'm glad because he is a trained guard up here as well. And so he had his training on Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. And then he had his facility tour earlier this week. Yesterday, he finally got his park pass. He's been waiting for a while to get that, about a week and a half. And they got those yesterday. But he has to book time in the parks. And I think, I can't remember if he's going tomorrow, which is Friday, or Saturday as his first day. And I think he's going to Hollywood Studios. So he's excited about that. And he can go on his time off. So if he has a day off, he can go to the parks if he can get in, if there's no blackout dates. And then he can also go either before or after a shift, but he's waiting to find out when his shifts are. And he's also waiting to be trained in the locations that he will be working. He'll be working at some of the resort pools. We are planning on going down to pick him up at the end of August. And what we're going to do is we're going to drive diagonally down through the US to Florida. And then on the way back, and I think I mentioned this last week, we're probably going to go along either the South Coast and then up the West Coast, or we'll go up so we can see the Grand Canyon. We haven't figured that out yet, but I mentioned I did buy a sleeping bag for Isaac. So we, Greg and I and Nathaniel, all have sleeping bags, but Isaac did not have a sleeping bag, and so we'll have to take that down with us because we are planning to tent it as we drive in that warm. Now, I'm going to say I try not to complain about the heat, but I am a little bit worried about tenting it in that heat. We've done it before. It does get hot. You just have to make sure you're out of your tent. You can't, you know, go for a mid-afternoon nap or you'll suffocate because it's too hot. But I am looking forward to a nice vacation. My parents are currently driving across Canada. They are in Saskatchewan right now, and they will be arriving in British Columbia on the weekend, and they'll be camping just north of Vancouver. So I'm planning on going up and setting up the tent, pitching that tent, making sure everything's all right with it, and spending a bit of time with them next week. So I'm not quite sure what the timing of next week's podcast will look like, whether I record a little earlier or record a little later. Things may look a little bit different next week, but I am looking forward to spending some time with my parents and testing out our new sleeping bag that we bought last summer. Anyway, I'm trying to think if there's anything else. Nathaniel is on a school trip today. They've gone to a place called Playland, which is kind of like an amusement park with roller coasters and things in Vancouver, I believe. So he was doing that today. And he's been enjoying fishing off of the dock. He hasn't caught anything yet, but he will tell you he has. I don't believe him. Anyway, trying to think if there's anything else to share. Just lots of crafting. Today, I'm going to have one of my neighbors over, and I mentioned earlier we're going to drink decaf tea, and we are probably going to do some English paper piecing or embroidery. So I'm throwing another challenge in there for myself to do something different again. I have two more projects that are not knitting and are not cross-stitch that... one is kind of knitting, that I would like to tackle in the next couple of weeks. So I think I need to put that pressure on myself to continue to get out of my comfort zone. And finishing off the Miss May Mystery Knit Along number 2 and just working slowly on other things, I think will hopefully afford me that time and energy to work on those things. Plus, I'm hoping one of those projects I'd like to send back with my mom. So I really need to get a leg up on that one and just bite the bullet on my fears and just do it. That's what I need to do. And that one's a hand-sewn blanket. You that much. I've shared the materials for it. I just need to get it on the island, measure it out. It's the prep work. It's going to take me about 3 hours to prep it all out. But once it's all prepped out, then it'll just be a nice, relaxing project to work on. But I just need to prep it out. That's all. Anyway, that is all I have for Bits and Bobs this week. I wanted to get the big camera out to share this with you. So I'm zooming in. I hope it's clear. We've got the three tugboats working away today. So in the lead is Tug Away with a boom, and then Iron Horse is behind, and then way in the back is Logger, and the bridge is closing behind. And wait till you see the mountain. It looks absolutely gorgeous. Now I do have the big zoom lens on, so I don't know that it's focusing all that well, and because the camera's heavy with the zoom lens on, it is a little bit harder to see. Let's slowly move up here, and Tug Away. Iron Horse has taken the lead here, and we're gonna have some waves starting. I might get wet because take a look at these waves coming at us. Oh my gosh, I'm going to get wet because this is going to come up through. You're going to hear it in a moment. I'm going to slowly hop down here so you can see what happens when, I don't think you can see it. Basically, the water came up and splashed through. Anyway, lots of water. Bridge is almost fully closed. Logger is at the end of this boom. And oh my goodness, look how gorgeous the mountains look today. Or this evening. It's actually late evening, and clouds and the mountains almost blend. It's a beautiful evening. And super high tides. Always fun to watch. I'm trying not to go too fast, but to watch the tugboats pulling their loads. And I don't know if you can see all the way down there. Look how fast Iron Horse went. He's already way down at the end. That was fast. I wanted to share my garden with you and all of the ducks, but all along between the rub rails and the concrete of the shared dock, there are beautiful pansies. And I have to tell you, this area is very, very well fertilized by the ducks. Lots of duck poop. But look at all those gorgeous yellow pansies. And if I pop back over here, I think this one's my favorite, with the variations of purple in there and a little duck feather to go along with it. I just wanted to share with you that the freshet is still happening, and there is a lot of debris going down the river. I'm also going to point out this boat here. This is River Scout. That's the name. You'd think because it was called Scout, I'd be happy, but River Scout likes to plow by really, really fast. He normally tries to go by fairly slowly here, but then picks up the pace and often moves the houses. Oh, look, we have
a beautiful little visitor coming. Hello. I believe this is actually Prancer. Prancer is starting to look a lot bigger, and Prancer is the male, Dancer is the female. That's what I've determined. Anyway, lots going on. Debris, River Scout trying to go slow, my Prancer. And I wanted to share with you, I showed you my garden, in quotes, on the other side. This is my strawberry plants that I transplanted out here. One of my neighbors gave me this container and I bought some dirt yesterday. And I have transplanted my strawberries from the click and grow that I have. Okay, so there's River Scout, and ready? He's picking up the pace. So he thinks he's just past the houses. The problem is this. He picks up the pace there, the weight comes back here and splashes the house. But he's been called on a few times. He's a water taxi from what I understand. Anyway, here come the waves. And this one here, I believe, wants some popcorn. I was actually wrong. This is Dancer. And the reason I figured that out was because when I came out with a tiny little bit of popcorn, Dancer came up and bit me and wiggled his tail. The popcorn's not ready yet. There's a tiny bit in the container. But yeah, sometimes I will put a little bit in my hand and I will reach it over and she will try and take it right from me, which is kind of fun. Last week I mentioned that the males are starting to molt, and these ones out here are looking pretty rough. There's three males in the back, these are the two females, and there is another male just right here. And they have lost their beautiful shiny head, and some of those back feathers are definitely looking worse for wear. But they are out trying to get what my beautiful swans are leaving behind. And there is another duck. He's got a little bit more of a shiny head. He hasn't quite started his full molt yet. But these guys over here, I gotta say, they're looking pretty rough.
Thank you so much for joining me on Knitting on the Float this week. I hope that you've had a chance to sit down and relax while I have chattered on about the knitting and the cross stitching that I've gotten up to this week. I'm so glad I took on my challenge. I need to add in the challenge of that hand-sewn blanket. That island is perfectly clear. I need to get to it. I just need to do that. So maybe in the next week and a bit, I will, and I'll be able to share some progress on that as well. I am wishing you the most wonderful week ahead. I hope it is a calm week, and that you are able to spend some time with your crafts of choice as you go through the next week and a bit. I am not sure whether I will see you next Thursday. It might be a little earlier, it might be a little later, but I will see you soon, and I look forward to sharing whatever crafty progress I've gotten up to with you at that point. Have the most wonderful week ahead, and I'll see you soon. Bye. So the way I happened upon these two wonderful cross stitch patterns was I absolutely love my Bird Leg Bags Nancy Drew sock bag. I love it so, so much. And I was looking online for that fabric, and I think I don't know what my search word was, but Nancy Drew, obviously. But when these came up a few weeks ago, I was smitten. And I sat and looked at it. I favorited it on Etsy and thought about it for a while and decided to bite the bullet. I did buy both of the patterns rather than just one because they go together. And it just all sparked by a project bag. Now, I do need a beautiful sewing bag for this project. And as I said, maybe next week we will see that.